executive editor with Furniture Today. And today I have John Merwin with Brooklyn Bedding in Arizona joining me. So welcome, John. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. So you guys just broke ground in Glendale, Arizona on your new manufacturing facility, close to 650,000 square feet, set to open in December. What's the driving factor behind Brooklyn Bedding's growth?
Right now, it's been our direct-to-consumer business, our e-com business has been really strong the last 3 to 4 years. And then as well as we do some white label manufacturing for some other brands. And then our retail business has rebounded nicely coming off of the COVID shutdown. So locally in the Phoenix market, our 18 stores are doing really well also.
Oh, that's great. And how many stores do you have?
18.
18. Perfect. And so when the new facility opens, what will it allow you to do that you're not able to do now?
Yep. It's just going to give us a lot more room to maneuver and then to keep up with the demand. Right now we're working out of two different facilities. And lost a ton of efficiency just moving product back and forth between the two facilities. So to get everything under one roof, and then right now we're capping out between 1,000 and 1,200 mattresses a day. And in this new facility, we'll have the ability to manufacture up to 3,500 a day.
Oh, wow. So you're more than doubling your production once you are up to full pack.
Yep.
Oh, that's great. So other than this factory that comes online later this year, what other growth plans is out there for you guys?
Right now, I'm just solely focused on this facility. And then the plan is after this one's up and we kind of learn what mistakes we made, because I'm sure we'll make some mistakes on design and build and different things like that. But then after that, the goal will be to open a facility on the East Coast.
Oh, wow. Do you know, the East Coast is long.
Yeah.
Any hints on where that would be?
No, because that's just my goal, right? And so about 9 months ago, I spent some time in the Carolinas actually looking for a facility before we had decided to break ground on this one. And we were close to possibly pulling the trigger and staying with what we had here and then opening up something on the East Coast. But in the end, we ended up breaking ground here in Phoenix. And then that will be the next step for us.
Great. And then you'd be bi-coastal.
Yep. And we send a tremendous amount of product, east of the Mississippi. So it will make sense for us at that time.
Oh, that's exciting news. I love that. I like it when people come on and have a little bit of, a tease as to what's coming ahead. So we'll have to stay in touch with you to stay on track with that. Yeah. December, is it just December or do you have a specific date for the opening yet?
No, we don't have a specific date. We're a couple weeks ahead of schedule right now. So I built the facility that I'm in right now. So I don't get too excited about getting ahead or being behind. We usually kind of hit the date that we're shooting for, but a lot of things got to come together. And so we're hoping to start moving the end of December.
Oh, very cool. So 2022 will be a big year for you for sure.
Yep. We're excited. And we need the space. We're busting at the seams right now. And it's going to be a lot of fun.
Nice. Well, listen, John, thank you for joining me. And I can't wait to catch back up with you and find out a status update on that new factory.
You bet. Thank you.
Thanks. Take care.